Who bewitched you? That's a question the Apostle Paul asked the Christians in Galatia during his lifetime. He asked them, who bewitched you? He called them foolish Galatians. He even began to wonder whether they suffered persecution for their faith in vain. Why? You can read it for yourself in Galatians chapter 3. I'm not going to read the whole chapter to you. I just want to put it in context for you. Paul was asking the Galatians, those who would read it, how come that you were walking by faith, but now some of those teachers amongst you who came in the name of Jesus, in the name of the Lord, they came around and they took you away from walking by faith, and now you're following all kinds of other teachings. I mean, to fall from grace doesn't mean that someone loses their salvation, which is impossible, because once the Holy Spirit has sealed you, you have been sealed. It can happen that you depart from the faith, that you're not operating by faith anymore. That means you're not operating in grace. And that's what happened to the Galatians. And how did this happen? By knowledge. Through false teachers, through agents of the enemy, amongst Galatians that use knowledge to keep them away from walking by faith. And unfortunately, it worked with them. Okay, let's go to today. When we think of the word bewitch, we tend to imagine a woman with the black clothes. There's some magic wand, and she speaks something in Latin or Babylonian, and someone's turned into a frog. That's the image Hollywood gives you. That's the image Disney gives you. A lot of people are influenced by those images or by those fairy tales. Now let's go to reality, how it works in reality. It's far easier and far more effective to bewitch a whole community or to bewitch a collective than to bewitch a single individual. What I mean with community, I mean people that live together in a location. I don't talk about a whole nation. I'm talking just people within a small region that live and cooperate together. It's far easier to bewitch a whole group like that, whether it's a church or a company, than is to bewitch one individual. Because if you would bewitch one individual, you still need the collective for the bewitchment to work out. So Paul asked the Galatians, who has bewitched you? Now there's a difference between being distracted and being bewitched. A distraction can happen without any intent, without any wrong intent. Let's say that you're driving the road and suddenly there's this big sound out there. Why there's a wedding going on and there's music. Now that music when you're driving a car can distract you. Now did those people intend to distract you, to cause an accident or whatever? No. It was just something that happened. Alright? What I mean it just happened, there was sound around, there was a wedding, and the sound distracted you, but it was no evil intent, there was no program behind it. So a distraction can be intended or not intended, but it's a distraction. To be bewitched is something far deeper. To be bewitched means that you, through the misuse of knowledge, you have been turned away, often without you being aware of it, from the walk of faith. And how does this happen? Through other people. Just look at the bigger picture. The enemy knows you are a human being with needs and with vulnerabilities. He knows other people also. The enemy knows that most people are not really interested in the truth, but most people just want to be relieved. So, when people perceive you as a threat, they'll act out against it with the knowledge they have. So what does the enemy do? The enemy, through his demonic agency, implants thoughts into other people, and those people that respond to those thoughts, they don't know those thoughts are not from them but from demons, those people begin to see you as a kind of danger, and people begin to, and the demons will point out a vulnerability of yours, and the people will see that vulnerability, and people will think that they are right for acting out against you or pointing things out to you. And at the same time, through those people, those demons are suggesting a way to you. And demons know, because you are human, because you want to be, because you have a zeal to please the Most High, because you don't want to be proud, you will listen to other people that will correct you. But you don't realize that those people correcting you are not really correcting you. They are bewitching you. Often they are doing it without you being aware of it. Why? Because it's not the Holy Spirit that drives them, but unclean spirits. So I'm going to close this audio recording now. Be at peace, remain in grace, and look at the bigger picture.